Hello students, welcome to my channel Engineers Academy. Let's solve this particular problem. In this problem it is said that determine the coordinates of the centroid of the shaded area, right? So we are given this area and we have to locate the centroid of this shaded area. So we have to determine the coordinates of that shaded area, right? So we have to find x bar and y bar of the centroid of this shaded area, right? So again we will apply the principle of moments equation. Let's say, so if you want to find x bar, so for x bar we can write that x bar into area, and this will be equal to xcda, right? So to apply this equation, first we have to select a differential area element, right? So let's say that this is my differential area. Let me draw some horizontal lines, right? So let's say that this is my differential element. Let's say that this is our differential element. So as we can see that this differential element is located at a distance of y from the x-axis, right? Let's say that this is its location, right? This is at a distance of y. And similarly, let's say that the centroid of this area is somewhere here. This is located somewhere here. So this will be the centroid of this differential element will be at a distance of xc from the y-axis, right? So this is xc, this length is xc, right? And this total length of this element will be equal to x, right? So we can say that this total length is x, right? If I define this total length, right? So this total length is x. So xc is the half of this this length, right? So xc will be equal to x divided by 2. And as we can see that the area, the differential area, the area of this differential element will be equal to this x, and this is our dy, right? So this is dy. So we can say that its area will be equal to x into dy, right? And we are given this equation, right? So let me write it in this equation, right? So we will have x bar a, xc is x divided by 2, right? And dA is x into dy, right? Since the integration is with respect to y, we have to add up the moments of all the differential elements along the y-axis, right? So then the maximum value of the y coordinate is a, right? So we will integrate this from 0 to a, right? And since the integration is with respect to y, so we have to write x as a function of y, which is given, right? So now we can write that this is x bar a, and this is this will be x square divided by 2 dy, and this is from 0 to a. And since x is equal to k y square, then x square will be equal to k square y to the power 4, right? So I can write that this is x bar a, and this will be, we can replace this x square by this, right? So this is k square y to the power 4 divided by 2 dy, right? So now we can integrate this, right? Since we have the y term here, this is from 0 to a, right? So before applying this, first we need to have the total area of for this given area, right? We have to find the area of this diagram, right? Where this shaded area. So how to find that area? We can say that the total area will be equal to the integration of dA. We have to add up all the areas of the differential element, right? Like this, right? So we have to add up all those areas along the y-axis, right? So we have to differentiate, integrate this from 0 to a, and we can write that this is from 0 to a, and the area is again this x dy, right? So I will write that this is x dy, and again we can replace that x by this equation. So this will be from 0 to a, and x is k y square dy, and we can say that this is k, and if we integrate this, so this is y cube divided by 3, and this is from 0 to a. So we will have ka cube divided by 3.
So now from this equation we can find this k value, right? So we can write that k is equal to x divided by y square from this equation, right? And as we can see that at this particular point when x is equal to b, y is equal to a, right? So I can write that when x is equal to b, y is equal to a, right? So this is b divided by a square. So I will write that this is b divided by a square into a to the power 3 divided by 3, right? So this will cancel out. So we will be left with, we can say that the total shaded area is equal to 1 divided by 3 ab, right? So now we can extend this equation. So we can write that now this area is 1 divided by 3 ab, and this will be equal to, and now we can write k square as well, right? So k square will be, if I take square of this equation, so this will be b square divided by a to the power 4, right? And we can write this 1 divided by 2 outside of the integration. So 1 by 2 from 0 to a, and k square y to the power 4 dy, and in place of k square we can write this, right? So this is b square divided by a to the power 4, right? So we can write, we can integrate this, so this will be b square divided by 2a4, and this will be y to the power 5 divided by 5, and this is from 0 to a, right? So this will be b square divided by 2a4, and if we apply these limits, so this will be a to the power 5 divided by 5, right? And we can write that this is x bar 1 divided by 3ab, right? So this a to the power 4 will cancel out, this x bar into 1 divided by 3ab. So we can write this as a into b square, and 2 into 5 is 10, right? So now this a will cancel out and this b will cancel out, right? So we can say that x bar is 3b divided by 10, right? So this is the x coordinate of the centroid of this given area. So now to find the y coordinate of the centroid of this shaded area, we will apply this equation, right? So now I will write y bar into a, and this will be yc into dA, right? Let me write that x bar is 3b divided by 10, right? So now I can write that y bar and area is that same 1 divided by 3ab, and this is y, and dA is that x equals x dy, right? So I will write this as x dy, and now yc, so the location of the centroid of this differential element from the x-axis is y, right? This, since this centroid is located at a distance of y, so then yc is equal to y, right? So we can write that this is y into x dy, right? And since the integration is with respect to y and the y is from 0 to a, so we will integrate this from 0 to a. And similarly, we will replace this x as a function of y, since integration is with respect to y, right? So I will write that this will be y, and x is equal to ky square, right? So this is ky square dy, right? Or we can write that this would be ky cube, right? We can write that this is ky cube, right? From 0 to a. And we know that k is equal to b by a square, right? So now I can write this is b by a square y cube dy, and this is from 0 to a, right? So now we can write b a square, and if I integrate this, so this will be y to the power 4 divided by 4 from 0 to a. So if we put these limits, so then this will be b divided by a square a to the power 4 divided by 4 minus 0, right? So we will be left with this thing, right? So I can write that this is y bar 1 divided by 3ab. So this will cancel out, so we will be left with square a square. So here we will have a square, right? And this b will cancel out, let me write it like this first, right? So this will 1 divided by 3 AB. So this will be 1 divided by 4 A square B, right? So now 1 A will cancel out and 1 B will cancel out. So we will be left with Y bar. This will be equal to 3 divided by 4 A, right? So this is the Y coordinate of the centroid of this shaded area. So now let's say that if you want to find the locate that centroid, right? So as we have determined that X bar is 3B divided by 10, right? So the centroid is somewhere here, right? So this distance is X bar, which is equal to 3B divided by 10. And Y bar is 3 by 4 A, right? So this length is, this is Y bar, which is equal to 3 divided by 4 A. So I hope you people would have understood this problem, right?